Erin Burnett Out Front, weeknights at 7, only on CNN.
I am Adam Lanza's mother. That title for a blog posting by a mother in Boise, Idaho, went viral about literally the instant after it was published. Liza Long wrote vividly about her 13-year-old son, Michael. Now, she changed his name, she says, to protect his privacy. Here's what she wrote. I live with a son who is mentally ill. I love my son, but he terrifies me. A few weeks ago, Michael pulled a knife and threatened to kill me and then himself after I asked him to return his overdue library books. Now, this blog was, it was very raw and emotional, and it raised questions about parenting a child with mental illness. And also, there were a lot of critics, people wondering why Liza Long would choose to be so public about her son, Michael. I spoke to her earlier today, and I asked her why she wrote the blog.
I have to face up to the fact that I have a sick son, and we need help. And Erin, that's really what the blog post was about. It was a cry for help in a situation where I was feeling very helpless. When I try to describe Michael to people, anyone who knows him knows that, you know, 97% of the time, he is just the sweetest, brightest, kindest, most articulate child. But sometimes for no apparent reason, he will just turn into this absolute raging, I don't know how to describe it.
Has it ever been diagnosed?
We've had a variety of diagnoses. We've looked at oppositional defiant disorder, intermittent explosive disorder. He's been looked at for autism spectrum disorder, although there's some disagreement on that. And then also finally ADHD.
He's now at what you call an acute inpatient facility, a mental health institution, and you actually took him there after the knife incident. Again, I want to quote Liza for our viewers who don't know your blog. When you write about that moment, you wrote, I'll read it, Michael was in a full-blown fit, screaming and hitting. I hugged him close so he couldn't escape from the car. He bit me several times and repeatedly jabbed his elbows into my rib cage. I'm still stronger than he is, but I won't be for much longer.
My son does know about this piece, and his take on it was, Mom, if we can help people to understand, then this is a good thing.
You wrote things about your son's behavior. I'll quote you again. It makes me want to throttle you. And then you said, I quit. Let the state take care of you. Another time you wrote, my daydreams all involve my own death or federal prison.
I think one of the hallmarks of my writing and one of the reasons that this last piece connected with so many people is I do have a tendency to just kind of say what's on my mind. And, you know, I wrote those words and those are my words. I'm not disowning them. But, you know, you're looking at a four-year slice of history.